Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, the one man funds a poppin', Soupy Sales.
Thank you, and thank you, Johnny Olson. It's a pleasure to welcome back the wonderful actress of the Broadway stage and matinee dancer at Roseland. Would you please welcome Sandy Duncan?
Thank you. I know a lot of hippies, but the original hippie is Henry Moore.
He certainly is.
And here we have one of the most certainly ladies altogether in the entire industry, I'm sure you'll agree personally, Arlene Francis.
And here's Jolly Wally.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome everyone to What's My Line. That was quite an entrance, Arlene. Very reminiscent.
I feel a little like Gone with the Wind.
Do you really?
Uh-huh.
Well, maybe that's because you're seated next to Henry. Huh? No, I didn't
that's
mean that.
That's a breeze.
But let's meet our first challenger. So, will you enter and sign in, please? Mr. X. Panel, this is Mr. X, and may I tell you that Mr. X is concerned with a product. And now let's show our audience just who our guest is and what his product is. And we'll begin with Henry Morgan.
That's your first mistake today. Mr. X, is your name associated with the product?
Yes, it is.
Is the product named after you?
Sometime.
Does it go in and out, up and down?
Sometimes.
In clarification, Henry, may I say that this gentleman is the innovator of a particular product. There are copies now which are about, but this gentleman is the innovator.
Okay. Is this product used mainly by one sex?
Yes, it is.
Men?
No.
One down, Arlene.
Is this product something that is seen on the person?
Yes.
On women?
Yes.
Is it seen if somebody were to come into my house and I had this on, would the person be able to see it immediately?
Hopefully.
Is it something other than a dress?
Yes.
Is it what might have been called at one time something in the lingerie line?
No.
Two down, Soupy.
Well, in all fairness to Mr. X, who I'm sure if I hear the name I would know, can I rule out that your name is Valentino?
You can rule that out.
All right. No, no. I'm sure if I hear the name, I'll know. It's because I don't recognize you on sight. But would the clothing be the new sensation hot pants?
That's
yes.
It.
Is that right?
May I formally introduce you to hot pants fashion designer Halston. And not to make a pun, but Halston is probably one of the hottest young fashion designers today. He has won 2 Cody Awards, and he has been chosen as the American representative to an international fashion event in Mexico. Now, for whom do you design?
Well, I think I design for the contemporary woman of any age, really.
You don't think that any particular age is involved
in
hot pants?
I don't really think so, depending upon the legs. If you can wear a bathing suit, you can wear hot pants. But I make, well, for a lot of star people like Liza Minnelli and Ally McGraw, and I do things for Mrs. Onassis and Mrs. William Paley, all sorts.
So all age groups? And
all age groups and all types.
Right. Now, you got a special Cody Award for the total concept in fashion. What does this mean?
Well, that meant that it was everything. It had to do with hats and wigs and ready-to-wear and shoes and accessories and everything.
So you don't just design the hot pants themselves?
No, I do everything.
You do the whole and
Absolutely.
Complete outfit. Well, as I am sure that you were all hoping, panel, Halston has arranged a hot pants fashion show for
Not
us.
Bad.
Yeah.
Good.
How about
yeah.
that?
Good.
Yeah.
All the guys are going, yeah.
And just so none of you miss anything, particularly Henry and Soupy, we've got special seats for the four of you, so Lloyd, may we open the curtain, please? And panel, you see four chairs. Arlene and Henry, would you take one set, and Sandy and Soupy the other set, please? Is everyone comfy? All right, if everyone is comfy, may I say, on with the show.
This is Naomi Sims in my newest wig and head-hugging fashion called Marla. It closely follows the hairstyles of the 40s. This is available in 20 shades. Naomi's wig is a great contrast to the bright red hot pants jumpsuit and flowing red wool jersey cape. The cape is bordered in black braid and the belt is designed with silver hearts. Black boots are the perfect leg fashion.
And thank you, Naomi.
Karen. Fashion right for almost anywhere is Karen. She's wearing the Halston wig called Laura. This is a really two wigs in one. It can be worn forwards and backwards and gives two different looks. The scarf around her neck adds a dramatic touch to Karen's blue suede jacket that is worn over a t-shirt and complements her matching hot pants. The total look is complemented with the leather jockey boots.
Lovely. Thank you, Karen.
Here's Pat Cleveland, sporting one of my newest wigs for Abbott Tresses, the Mindy, which is another turnabout. Worn this way, it's a mass of curls. Turned around, it's smooth and sleek. Pat is wearing a man-tailored vest with buttons up the front over a classic sweater with matching shorts. Her leg fashion is full-on jockey boots.
Thank you, Pat.
And here's Heidi. Under her turban, she's wearing my new Hetty wig for Abbott Tresses. The jacket is really a short-sleeved body shirt with its own belt, which creates a one-piece look. Pure silk jersey and brilliant purple is the hot pants story for our last model.
Lovely, and thank you, Heidi. All right, panel, if you can tear your eyes away, that means you can now return over here to your desk, huh? But thank you, Halston. It was a pleasure having you with us on What's My Line.
Thank you. Did
you say goodbye to the panel? What's My Line will continue right after this word. Well, that was fun. Henry and Soupy, did you particularly enjoy that?
I thought it had its moments, yes.
Yes, it certainly did.
What do the ladies think of it? Would either of you wear hot pants?
We were just talking about that, and, you know, I think it was very young, but I would be embarrassed about a skirt or something on the street.
How about you, Arlene?
Uncomfortable.
No, I'd wear it underneath a
skirt.
Hoop skirt.
I have a pair on under my long pants.
Really? I thought they were just for women.
Well, you put me in a pair of high heels, you can take me any place.
Let's meet our next challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Randall Jinx. And where are you from, sir?
Tucson, Arizona. The warm state.
The warm state. All right, panel. Randall Jinx is a second lieutenant in the United States Army. Now, his job in the Army is very unusual. Let's show the audience just what his unusual line is. we'll begin with Miss Francis.
Thank you, Wally. Mr. Jenks does the, Lieutenant Jenks, does what you do in the Army have anything to do with the way the men look in any way?
No, ma'am.
One down, Soupy.
Mr. Jenks, Lieutenant Jenks, what you do, does it have, or does it ever have anything to do with the ladies of the Army Corps?
It can. Yes. It can. Mm-hmm.
It can.
It mm-hmm. can.
Now, when you have something to do with them...
it's illegal.
It's illegal. That's we'll do a team, Henry.
My wife says it's illegal.
Your wife says, okay. No. Now, you really have something to do with them. Are you ever in charge of them in any way?
Definitely.
Can we rule out that it has anything to do with sports?
Yes, you can.
Okay, now you've got to be in... Are you in charge of a battalion of whacks?
I'd like to be, but the answer is no.
No. Two down, Sandy.
Does it have anything to do with entertainment?
No, ma'am.
Three down, Henry.
Is what you do with these people in any way instructive?
It can be instructive.
Not primarily instructive, but there may be a bit involved.
Well, are you an example of anything?
I'd say about as much as you are.
I never thought of myself that way. What I meant was, do you demonstrate something that the others learn from you?
Sometimes. That's
but not
a part
not,
of it.
Not really,
be
though,
a part of it.
Very small part, Henry. So yeah. Small, I'm going to give you a no on it. One, Arlene. All right.
Do you, whatever your service is, do you do it or can you help or show or instruct more than one person at a time?
Yes, ma'am.
You have nothing to, do you, may I rule out that you have anything to do with AWOL or anything like that?
You may rule that out, ma'am.
Do you, the way he says, ma'am, I feel 110.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Do you have anything to do with the motion, the traveling of any of these people?
No.
Five down, Soupy.
Can we rule out, Lieutenant Jinx, that sports are involved?
You may.
You did.
We've already ruled that out. Do you have a guess? Our time is up. I'm flipping all the cards and telling you that Lieutenant Jinx is an Army nurse. But the lieutenant is assigned to the U.S. Army Medical Corps at Fort Huachuca, Arizona. And isn't it a little unusual?
It is very unusual for a man to be a nurse. Currently, out of... all the nurses in the United States, 2% are men.
You don't live in the nurses' quarters, do you?
Well, like I said, my wife would rule that out.
Oh, your wife would rule it. Well, how did you happen to go into nursing, Randy?
Well, it's very easy. I had a football injury which needed repair, and I went to a hospital, and the fellow who took care of me was a male nurse, and he got me interested in nursing.
Do any funny things happen to a male nurse?
Yes, there are. One day I was walking in the ward up at Hartford, Connecticut, where I trained at Hartford Hospital School of Nursing. And by the way, I'm the first male graduate in the 90-year history of the school. Thank you. And what happened was there was a lady doctor, and she was taking her medical internship, and we walked into a room where there was a lady with kidney problems, and she looked at the doctor, and she said, good afternoon, nurse. And I said, and she said, I'm the doctor. And she looked at me and she said, who are you? And I said, I'm your nurse. And she dropped out of the bed.
Well, Randy, I think it's a very worthwhile profession, and I'm delighted that men are going into it, and you're a good example of one who should be.
Thank you.
So thank you for joining us.
Yes, sir.
What's My Line? We'll continue right after this word. All right, and once again, we've reached that very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guest. Panel, are the blindfolds securely in place?
Yes, Wally.
All right, mystery challenger, will you enter and sign in, please?
Hello.
All right, panel, our mystery guest has arrived. I'll remind you it's one question at a time. I'll give you 2 minutes to try and establish our guest's identity, and we'll begin with Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Wally. Mystery guest, that was a marvelous ovation. Is that because you're well-known due to your appearances on television?
No. Sandy.
Are you known for your work in the theater?
No. Henry.
Are you well-known?
Yeah. Arlene.
Are you well known in the sports world?
Yep.
Soupy.
Oh, he's well known in the sports world. Is that because you are a champion or you have been a champion?
I don't think you could ever call this gentleman anything else.
Yep.
Sandy?
Yeah, let's find out what sport. Baseball.
Yeah.
Henry.
Well, that was a yeah for baseball. All righty. Are you a pitcher?
Yep.
Arlene.
Well, I just read a terrific story about someone that has been beloved over a long period of years and the Hall of Famer. Are you Satchel Paige?
Yes. This is a man that would have rewritten every record book on baseball had he been permitted to play in the major leagues in his prime. Really, in the younger years. Satch, don't you agree?
Yes, I come along. They got a little confused about my age.
Well, everybody's still a little confused about your age.
Well, I come up to tell it, but I think I better hold it. I thought maybe you did have some kind of dream about it, what... how old I was, but I see it's the same thing I was when I was with Cleveland, so I'm going to just say I'm a little over 60. Now, yeah. And it's the funny thing, I'm the only man in the United States that don't nobody know nothing about his age, and I'm a photo people all the time.
Well, I heard that Bill Veeck knew how old you were.
Well, Bill Veeck do, but Bill Veck's not going to tell it. He's not too far from here now. He and I are together.
It's estimated that Satchel Paige pitched about 2,500 baseball games. And of those, he won over 2,000 out of 2,500 games. What a fantastic record that is. How many years did you pitch? Can you tell us that, Satchel?
Well, I pitched 42 years altogether with grade school and in the Southern League up until I got to the Major League in 1942. To tell you how many games I've pitched, I couldn't tell you because I played winter and summer. And I've pitched about a year where it started in the spring, and I've pitched in a game, pitched as high as 160 ball games. Pitched every day.
When did you finally wrap it up?
I wrapped it up 2 years ago in Atlanta when I was with Atlanta playing some exhibition games.
Well, did Dizzy Dean really help, break it down for you so you could get into the majors?
Yes, he did. When he first won the World Series, he started the barnstorming women talking about how great I was, and then the rest of the players got out to the tops like Joe DiMaggio and Ted Williams, and it really helped me to get in.
Satchel, if I'm not mistaken, don't you hold the record for the largest attendance of a nighttime ball game of all times when you pitch for Cleveland?
Yes, I do. That was in Cleveland. I had 78,941.
Yes, Henry.
I have the rules home that Satchel Paige made up, the rules to live by. There are about six of them. And my favorite, and I'm going to say it wrong, of course, because I had to open my big mouth. Satchel Paige said years ago, never look behind. Something may be gaining on you.
Well, Satchel, we're delighted that you're in the Hall of Fame. I can't think of anyone who deserves it more, and we're also so pleased you could join us on What's My Line.
Well, I'm very glad to be here, too.
Thank you. Thank you. Satchel Paige. What's My Line will continue right after this word. And now, panel, we have exactly 60 seconds for honest answers. To Soupy. Dennis Camber of Skokie, Illinois, says he saw you in Hell's a Poppin' 67 and Expo 67 in Montreal. And he says, that's part of your career I never heard about. Tell us about it.
Well, when they had Expo 67 in Montreal, Canada, Alexander Korn got the rights from the Olson and Johnson estate for Hell's a Poppin', and he put together the show, and we did it for 14 weeks, 7 days a week, two shows a night at Expo. And it was a big hit.
Good.
And it was very exciting.
Very good. I didn't know you had done that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. All right. And to Arlene, do you have a big social life, or does radio and television work keep you very busy?
I have a reasonable social life at night, but for the rest of the time, I'm busy with radio and television. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes to both, really.
Yeah.
Thank you for your honest answers. Well, with our army nurse in the hot pants and Satchel Paige, I think it all fit together fairly well today. And I hope you'll join us tomorrow, because we're going to try to make the pieces fit then, too, on What's My Line?